What you call an icon living? Start a record label, Miss Fish just did it. Nylon, cover 5 minutes.
Hey everyone, so I saw Gemini Man. Now, I haven't seen Ang Lee do action films since the 2003 Hulk movie with Eric Bana. Now, I didn't have hopes when I first saw the trailer, but finally checking it out, I actually liked it a little more than I thought. Will Smith did a very good job. I really like how he just kind of delivered a lot of emotion, especially when kind of conversing with himself, his clone. The action was tight, the visual and special effects were just mind-blowing. Ang Lee knows how to work with technology. I did wish the movie ran a bit longer, maybe more story, more material, because it took them an hour to get to everything you knew from the trailer. Now, if you didn't see the trailer, good job, you're gonna enjoy this movie. But if you have, it's just no surprise that there is a clone in the works when it comes to Will Smith, because that's what they're trying to figure out in the first hour, and you're like, duh, isn't it the same guy? This isn't Bad Boys for Life. I mean, they could have just had Jaden Smith, Will's son, to just get thrown in there and just juice it up a little bit. Now, getting into some of the tech stuff, this is the first feature film I actually got to sit down and watch it in 4K, and I know that the film was already shot in 66 frames per second. You get a lot of the deepest darks, the brightest colors, and a lot of the landscape stuff, even water, just look really real, you know, just like I could touch it. And then there lies in the problem, because I felt like I was watching the dailies of the movie itself, kind of like a rough draft, but in high definition picture. And it was so weird because I could see all the special effects stuff. I could see all the visual effects stuff. It was just very distinct. It was so real that the action looked way too fake. I could even tell when they were riding on the motorcycle that it was just half speed. You can tell when Will Smith got switched off with a stuntman or with a visual effects whole situation because of the overacting. And you see right through the actor's performance. It's scary. You see how light the prop guns are and the rubber glass just falling down. It's ridiculous. It's almost laughable because I could tell what was a set and what was an actual location, what was real, what was fake. I mean, it was amazing, amazing high def, all the technology, wow. But it was almost like you're watching like a film school project at its best. Now, I'm not going to dock this movie with my viewing experience because I got to rewatch it again on Blu-ray, and that is the standard that I'm used to. That is what my eyes are comfortable with because just some things are just moving way too fast. Woo! I know it was one thing to get adjusted from DVD to Blu-ray, but I mean, to go from Blu-ray to 4K is just one big technological step, but it was an amazing experience. Hope you guys enjoyed it for what it was, but I'm gonna stick with my 1080p. That's just me.
Oh, we are too hot in the business. Ooh, about to make a movie independent. Ooh, need new trucks independent. Ooh, I need you to listen to the vision. Ooh, all your verses sound like dirty.